Welch with the Terrell Welch Gallery, and this morning we're talking about Last View, Chesterman Beach, Tofino Tsunami. It's a 30 by 40 inch oil painting that was done in 2016 in the spring. This painting, with the Wiconishi Inn about to be engulfed by a giant wave, is imagining the unimaginable that is within the realm of possibility someday, or is it any day, standing on Chesterman Beach, listed as one of the top five wild beaches in the world, is breathtakingly beautiful. However, it is also within the tsunami warning area for the Cascadia subduction zone, a mega thrust fault, which is 1,000 kilometers long dipping fault that stretches from northern Vancouver to the Cape of Minas Docina, California. A full rupture of this fault happens on an average of about every 500 years. When it happens, again, it is thought it will deliver a 9-magnitude earthquake that could last up to 6 minutes and then be followed 20 minutes later by a devastating tsunami. The only advice is to run, not drive, to the nearest high ground that would take almost the same amount of time to reach. Odds of survival if a person were standing on Chesterman Beach during the specific moment of such an event does not seem that likely. The tsunami could reach heights of 100 feet. The last full rupture is believed to have happened at night, sometime in the winter of the early 1700s. Oral history and geological evidence suggest whole villages were swept out to sea or buried in landslides as people slept. Still, we go. We stand there in awe and we say silently to ourselves, not today, please not today, but what a magnificent last view it would be. Okay, so this isn't a particularly easy painting to view, or for that matter even to talk about. Where it's situated in the gallery at the moment, it's not the first painting you see as you come in. So when you come in, you end up walking across the room, then turning around, and then you notice this painting. And the response is usually something like, that is terrifying and beautiful, or that is extremely scary. And it's interesting because people will position themselves so they'll glance at me, they'll glance at the painting, but their main focus is on the door, on the, so that they're, you know, can leave. How this painting came about is I was on a vacation with my daughter and my two grandsons who were preschoolers. We stayed in a cabin that would be right about here on this beach. High tides in the winter actually wash right up to the edge of the cabin when there's storms. Of course, I had read about this, the Cascadia subduction zone and the possible of a full rupture earthquake. Figured out quite quickly that we probably, with two young children that were heavy enough that they were difficult to carry, would have a hard time, even with adrenaline, to be able to get to higher ground if we woke up immediately and left. It sort of haunted me after I came back home, and I just couldn't get the idea or the image out of my mind. because it is incredible. Anybody who's been to this beach knows how incredibly beautiful it is and how stunning those waves are when they come in. It's a place where the surfers go to surf on Vancouver Island. And so I did more research about what often people's responses are, and what does a tsunami wave look like? And basically, it's a great big wave, and it's so mesmerizing that people sometimes just freeze. They're not able to move, and the wave washes over them. And so I decided that I would try this idea of trying to imagine what, if you were standing here, what 80 to 100 foot wave would look like with Wikinish Inn in the background. And the way the waves come in, it would get hit secondary to the water coming forward right onto Chesterman Beach. It's kind of at the end of the beach. And so I painted all of my fear and anxiety into this painting. And it was commented that, you know, I don't very often do things that are from my imagination, because I usually have a physical reference, even if I'm all created at a different time or whatever. But it was quite, it's imaginary in the sense of its size, but not in its structure. It's a large wave with its power, the wind whipping those tails over top, going backwards, and it has this sense of being, you know, ferocious. And of course, this landscape, part of the landscape, is actually really there. I can't imagine that somebody would want this painting on their wall. It's one of those paintings that will likely stay in my artist collection for an indefinite amount of time. And some of that is just people's responses to it, that it's almost too terrifying to look at or to think about. But I when I was working on this, I was thinking about human behavior and you know, the things that we can change and we cannot change. We can choose to live with outside of the reach of where this tsunami could reach us, yet we don't. You know, there's the whole cottage village and a huge tourist industry for this beach. So we take that risk, and even knowing that it's possible that that might happen. And it's something we have no control over. We can't influence the shifting tectonic plates of the earth. Those things will continue to happen as they have always happened, creating change in the topography of the world. And it makes me think about climate change and how we resist doing anything or significant amount from a policy, governance place to mitigate rising sea levels and loss of environments and loss of wildlife and humanity. And when we look at our behavior and the risks we will take, we as human beings are not really very good at assessing and changing direction based on when it requires us to do something that we're comfortable with, or to use a word that's, you know, that almost we're addicted to, not as individuals, but as society, our dependency on fossil fuels. So somehow all of this were some of the thoughts that went into painting this tsunami wave that, like other humans, I had taken the risk to stay on that beach with my two small grandchildren. And so it's kind of questioning, why would I choose to do that? What was it that, you know, it wasn't like I didn't know at all about the risks that I was taking. And so it begs that question of our human psyche. And so anyway, that's last view on Chesterman Beach. Defino tsunami. And I'll leave you with that and my thoughts. And have a great Friday, and we'll talk to you next Friday. Take care for now. Bye-bye.